We're very grateful for the information about Enominat, Seraph.
I see my message has reached you then. So now you understand, correct? Enominat's suppression of your world is inevitable. To resist would be futile.
Futile this, futile that. How can you be so sure? Are you controlling Enominat?
Yes and no. Allow me to explain. Empyreans and Malakim once resided in the Heavenly Realm. At the time, they were known as Seraphim.
Malakim and Seraphim are the same thing?
Essentially, Malakim are merely Seraphim who descended from the Heavenly Realm. And the Prime Lords who ruled over them eventually came to be called Empyreans.
So then, a Malak is one who serves the Empyreans. Got it.
But the real name for them would be Seraphim.
It's only natural that this knowledge has been lost to you. Tens of thousands of years have passed since we left the Heavenly Realm. Indeed, nearly all Malakim on the surface world are ignorant of the oath made all those years ago upon their ancestors' descent.
Wait! What's this oath you're talking about?
I guess we'll just have to keep going to find out.
Grow.
I found you, Mew!
I think that's supposed to be my line.
What's my reward? Probably a cat's towel, right?
Again, my line.
Alrighty, here's the cat's towel you've been waiting for, Mew!
I should wrap you in this towel and swing you around for a while.
You aren't taking the warp?
What am I doing?
That would have been a remarkably poor decision.
Very poor decision.
You know, there's really... Well, I guess we really should buy more life bottles.
I mean, if we wanted to blow the cat souls here because we have enough, we could just get all of our life bottles back right here.
Because I'm not that worried about us failing, honestly. Are you?
Yep, there. That's all of our life bottles back. I am not.
I'd worried about doing that for.
But hey, we're here. I'm gonna do this real quick.
They really should allow you to rename the life bottles to Rokuro bottles.
I don't think
most people who play this game have the experience we've had, which is... These characters are all so interesting, they all work so well together, other than Rokuro, who's just horrible. This is the last floor,
yep.
Isn't it? The last real floor.
Yeah. I now have...
So, any guesses on whether Rokuro is going to get experience from the next boss?
Because
I'm certainly not going to put a great deal of effort into keeping him alive.
Neither am I. I certainly didn't last fight when I chose to use that mystic art there. It's like, oh, full power hits and the boss is stunned and I'm hitting him with Venom Strike?
After, you know, Lava said it used, I think, like three different Soul Bursts that combo,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, you saw how hard that hit, didn't you? That was...
I mean... When we got any sort of combo going, you just saw how rapidly Bright Shade was building Soul.
Yeah.
I was throwing up that blue barrier at pretty much the rate of Lafayette's barrier meter drain, and I was sitting at 5.
I was cycling between all of Aizen's and Velvet's resources pretty quickly. And I did 2 level 5 Mystic Arts with Aizen during that fight. That thing got wrecked. I think we have enough cat souls. What about you?
We have a few. First time I've seen a 4-digit number on that.
It's how hard Aizen's the final stage of his soul burst hits is ridiculous.
What's even the activation condition for the dual Mystic Arts?
There isn't one. Just have 5 meters with both characters. One of the characters has to be in the reserve spot. And you just hit the Mystic Art button plus the direction of the character you're doing the dual Mystic Art with.
Well, okay, the activation condition. That's quite a few conditions. One of the characters, they both have to have 5 meters. One of the characters has to be in the reserve slot and you have to do that input.
But you know what I meant, though. There's no, like, special conditions like there were for a lot of the others. It's pretty much just half the resource. I guess the command that you have to input is different, but...
And you have to have the other side of the reserve slot, which is... That's very much a condition. I could do the dual Mystic Art with... I mean, the Lafayette Velvet one, the way we tend to arrange our party, is the only one that could plausibly happen. Because, you know, AI Rokro and Boglu just tend to be in.
Yeah. You know, I still haven't seen... I should probably just view Boglu in Eleanor's. Because I've seen the other two. Aizen and Ropharos is kind of amusing.
Does Aizen do all the work? Because that would be the only thing that would make sense.
They pin the enemy between them and just bat them back and forth.
And we can assume that all the damage output is from Aizen.
Probably.
It ends, Rokro falls or dead because Aizen's attacks were so strong they killed Rokro too.
Or it just does the full animation, and when you come out of it, Rokuro's just inexplicably dead. Wouldn't that be better?
I mean, if Aizen's attacking in Rokuro's direction, I expect Rokuro to die. When enemies who are much weaker than Aizen attack Rokuro, Rokuro dies. It was really nice in the story how much Kurogane believed in Rokuro. Because there was no reason for anyone else to believe in Rokuro. Like, even canonically, his whole life was being hopelessly outclassed by Shigure.
Kurogane was very much the story of the believe in the me that believes in you.
I just want you to know that didn't seem obnoxious at all.
I want you to know it's not.
It's just great,
it's
right?
The best. You know, when I was in here the other day and that was happening to me over and over again, I was just thinking to myself, you know, I bet... I can just imagine what Chris's reaction would be to watching this.
You know, I think you missed the chest back there. Not up top, but on the lower part.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, I saw this one on the first pass, but at first I thought you were just taking some kind of route, and then I realized you'd missed it after you were already far from it, and I knew it'd be faster to get it on the way back. All Divide would be a real useful item for this upcoming challenge.
Yeah, we need our damage output to be as high as possible. Let's cut it in half.
Man. Opening all these chests and seeing all these different things that we're not wanting to find. It's reminding me of not finding flippers. And this mechanic is great.
Oh wow, I flipped that one somehow.
Unfortunately.
You see why the... why this removing all of these is an important thing to do with the cats.
At least on this floor.
Yeah, stay away. I'm gonna have one that I'm missing, and that's gonna be annoying. Probably.
You're not sure if it's gonna be annoying?
Well, it's going to be annoying, but I'm not sure.
You started to explain and then realized that I understood you in the first place. I feel like, given the way the Tales universe operates and how many trolls are in it, there really should be a character who consistently asks for explanations of things they understood in the first place. Because it's a pretty fun gimmick.
Didn't Jade do a little bit of that?
A little, but not all that much. He mostly would just try to make Guy say as many things as possible.
Took Guy a little while to catch on.
It took Guy like half the story to catch on. And even when Guy caught on, he never figured out how to avoid it. It took Jade like the first quarter of the story to realize how easily trollable Guy was. So within the context of that game, more of those.
Are you gonna be sad now?
Heartbroken.
That was perfect.
You remember the part where Jay Nannis went back to try to ask Guy for help dealing with the church. You know, after they all split up.
Oh yeah, yeah.
It was never remarked just what a large compliment Jade was effectively paying Guy by saying, you know, I need to go specifically get your help.
I mean, he was the best physical attacker in that world.
By a lot. Certainly gameplay-wise. But, like, it was totally out of Jade's, you know, normal mode of operation to go and ask a specific person for help and give the reason that because you think they're really useful. What does the Pirate King sea platter do? This is important. That could be... We never tested if those things are actually curry. We should test that against the final
boss. By the way, look at
this
enemy type. I just want you to enjoy that enemy type for a second.
That's a really crummy weakness. Oh, Bright Shade. Never mind. It's a great weakness.
That is a mustachioed individual with megaphones for hands.
Your point? I mean, that seems pretty ordinary to me. Aren't there mustachioed guys with megaphones for hands in all the games you play?
Hey, Rokuro died.
Oh, whoops, I didn't really mean to raw cast this, but I'm getting away with it, so I'll just let it happen. Is there gonna be a part where you attack with Aizen?
I mean, I was. Wow. Well, that was embarrassing. I just had the broadside of a bar in my mouth. Clearly taking this fight very seriously.
I assume there's more than these guys here.
Yeah.
Leave it to me!
What are these things weak to? Void. Let me revive the character who has the most potential to immediately help us. By that I mean Isaac.
I was hoping that's where that was going.
Okay, Aizen is alive. So now we have our full relevant party alive.
Maybe not.
That was a baffling switch. Yeah, I have no way to revive Aizen without.
I did the switch because
character. Velvet
was not in a good position.
Couldn't get away from them. One more of these souls in.
Looks like Velvet had no health and no meter, so.
The light of my conviction will pierce you.
Aizen had even less. And also no meter. Well, that got me all my soul back.
That was a level 3. Level 3s give 3 soul.
Set the habit! Come out! Five!
let's, Okay. These are weak to water. Run towards you.
I really love these scorpion enemies, don't you? Part where they have no soul.
No, I can't die here.
What? I was just holding it. I wanted to do the full chain. Instead, I go down to 2 soul, getting nothing useful for it.
Oh, I was doing that for you. So you with 4 souls still.
I'll help you.
Can't do anything. They just slow me every time they hit me. And I can't cast, I can't. I can do this. Please, something die.
Just throw a life bottle at hell.
Let's go. Don't even know if I can do that safely. And I'm slowed. I can't switch out either. I just have to deal with being slowed. You know they slow at a just hilarious rate.
Yeah. Enemies that don't have any soul are really, really dumb enemies to fight ever.
A couple of these go down, I can start reviving, but very dead.
Okay, so, note to self. When scorpions come out, it'll be Mystic Art time.
Another way to put it, if the scorpions are not out, it is not Mystic Art time. Or anything vaguely resembling it.
Yeah.
They have a ton of health, and it's absolutely impossible to generate resources against them. Great enemy type.
You know, every scorpion in the game is like that. We haven't fought random, so you wouldn't know, but when I was filling out the equipment book and the enemy book and all that stuff, I learned this stuff, and scorpions are a really dumb enemy type in this game. They're the only enemy type like that that I can think of.
Like, even when I stunned them, I didn't get a soul. It was...
because they only have that one, which means they can only give up a soul if they're killed. Because, you know, the last soul in every enemy's pool.
Yeah, but, like, generally... like, some of these... against enemies with multiple souls, you'll a lot of times get them even if the enemy doesn't have them to give. Against enemies with one soul, for some reason, it just doesn't matter. Nothing you do can possibly generate
you can
a soul.
Parries and stuff, little stuff that pulls from the soul instead of, you know, pulling from like their active souls, that pull from like the invisible soul pool, can make stuff spawn. Like parrying. That's the only way.
I think it's pretty safe to say that that enemy type should probably not exist.
Yeah. Remember that one boss that was like that? That was laughably easy, but very silly.
Because everyone got down to one soul, and he just had a million health and defense.
I don't remember him having that much defense.
I mean, it takes forever to kill him when everyone's at one soul. I think with Lothaset, I had three souls, and I was just refusing to use it for reasons I think are entirely obvious. I also really like how the chest counter, like, added right for 11.
Why? What did it look like?
It's, you know, like, the 11's too far to the side. Mm. They didn't line it up very well for a double-digit number.
I'm not that worried about treasure right now. Because this is the last thing we have to do. That made you smile, didn't it?
Always. Why would you ever choose to reduce thorns instead of eliminate thorns when it's only five more soul to eliminate?
I had the exact same thought.
Like, five is nothing.
Really, if you're abusing the random floors correctly, none of those costs are significant.
Yeah, but like... there's no context in which 5 is significant. Like, at the start of the game, 5 is not significant.
Pretty much.
A foe worth killing.
Hackaloo, really?
I did not get my meter back from all that. Lotha said it's now able to switch, but I would really prefer him to have more than just this, you know?
dark and light! Break it! Break it! Dark and light! Dark and light! Break it! Dark and light! Break it!
What are they actually weak to? Void, okay. It's a good weakness.
Very careful that these things hit really hard.
When they were right next to each other, that was really cool. Why is that even possible? I get hit out of my soul burst and slowed, so I just do no damage and lose all my soul at once. I go from 5 to 2.
I drop my guard to attack and just instantly get stunned and killed.
Yeah, I've had 5 this whole time. There's.
Dana, they seem to have really high focus.
The unfortunate thing is that when you died, it got rid of Mogulu, which greatly reduced what we can do with Mystic Arts.
This is a wash. It really is.
I mean, we have to leave anyway. We've used way too many life models. You died at a really bad time with that first death, and it did not get better.
I wish this game had a, just showed you where your stun meter was at so you'd know when you could do stuff. Hacking a visible stun meter into this game would be nice.
People would get really annoyed at it though because they would notice it never goes down until you get stunned. Because I'm pretty sure that's how it works. And a lot of times it starts with you on the precipice of being stunned. Because, you know, its initial value is random.
Yeah. But the fact that it never goes down can work in the player's favor in a lot of ways, too, though, because that also means that any work you've done to the enemy before you had to, like, back off or whatever is still, you know, there. Yeah, if we get to the scorpions without losing...
And, like, losing the AI is really not okay. For one, they're extra mystic arts. For two, they... When it's just the two of us alive, there's no way you can protect me. I can't cast. I can't help us win. We just lose, yep. You know? Like, when it's just Rokuro dead, it's not that bad. But it's setting up for the scenario where he and Magalu are both dead. Like, I thought we really had it when I managed to revive Magalu, because that was a big help. But then... we were just one, unfortunately, timed death away from... Magalu didn't really have a chance.
All I needed was one stun.
Yeah, getting stunned is basically an instant death in this
game.
Well,
I mean, I was saying that's all I needed, because if I had gotten that, then I could have gotten Velvet back out with Meter. Well, actually, Velvet was dead too, though, off the battlefield. That was the other big problem, is I couldn't switch to Velvet.
Well, Velvet's death was kind of the start of everything. That's the death I really meant. Because usually when Aizen's out and just sitting out and not able to get back out quickly, it's the sign that things are about to go very, very wrong.
Against a lot of enemies that... The scorpions can teleport to you. If they wasn't the scorpions, I could just run away and plunder in Ghost a few times and generate resources.
Because I do think overall casting is what's powerful in this game, but this isn't the sort of game where all four characters can be doing it, you know?
Yeah.
Because when Velvet's doing Velvet things, I can cast whatever I want. It's helpful, you know?
Yep.
And then Brightshade stuns every other time I cast it, and then the barrier just stays up, and then Velvet's not going to die because she takes half damage from everything, and it's kind of a virtuous cycle.
I don't think we have a chance.
Or all the what?
All the enemies in here are really stupid.
Can you hold the run button here to speed it up at all? Or?
I am holding the run button.
Awesome. I mean, I was pressing against the edge of the arena too, so I couldn't really tell. But...
I think you run slower when you're dead, but you still run.
That's a funny statement.
It's accurate on multiple levels.
I'm not sure how it's accurate on multiple levels. Dead characters are not very mobile.
They're very capable of running. We have demonstrated this time and time again. They just run slower.
I thing is, though, is even with how dumb some of the enemies here are, it's gonna be a lot easier to take on small groups of them. Especially because we'll be able to go into the fights with resources and full health. Whereas by the time those scorpions come out, we're usually not perfect.
If it's a fight of just the scorpions, that's a big problem. Unless we start with a bunch of blasts, which is likely not to be true. Those scorpions are completely broken. Like, this combat engine doesn't work against that enemy type.
Yeah.
A foe worth killing.
It's different.
These can be different. God, that hits so hard.
Not who I wanted to target. I wanted to target the ones chasing you.
I can't get up.
I can't do anything. As soon as the two AI were dead, I was done fighting.
Listen to me.
I figured you might try and throw a life bottle, but I guess you're done. You know what actually might be a good idea to be chucking in these fights? Because it's the last real fight we're doing. The last set of real fights we're doing. Elixirs. We have 9 of them. And they're basically an instant momentum returner. Because it's full health plus 3 blast. You know?
You know what we really need to do? Change Rokuro's AI to full defense. Because he'll just hang around and they'll target him and it'll really help.
That's a good point.
Engage at range is correct. We want him to run away and defend. Defense only. The rest of that doesn't even matter. He'll never attack. You know, he's just gonna... Because we've seen him in that setting before. He literally just runs away. Which is actually the best thing he can do, because things will target him and he'll just run from them. The AI in this game tends to get caught up on characters that run away from them. You know, they probably should just let you pick what floor type you get, because they might as well, just this is slower.
Spin cat souls too. Pick a floor type.
I'm just imagining they just straight let you pick. It's like, what would you like, a treasure chest floor, a cat soul floor, a bunch of enemies, or a geoboard challenge?
Hmm.
Like, I can tell what their design idea was. It's, oh, they'll go through this over and over again, and we're going to make it different every time. Except they totally didn't think through the implications of how their systems would work together. It's an absurd sum of money. Also, we have, like, five of those, and Mogloot, I do not believe that's one
that
equipped.
Was actually, I think, our third that we just got, but...
Oh, five. And what's that thing we just got from Office at? Probably better. Looks cool.
Sound logic. This is attacking stats.
This has defense on it.
Though it has a much higher stat in your primary attacking stat. And you have the option to equip that other belt that gives you a ton of art attack.
Okay.
You got a bag. That is ridiculously worth it. Do you want to lose a stat you don't use for substantial gains to two stats you do use? The extra art attack and just a mountain of extra focus for Lafayette. Pretty good. You should have an option on the menu, just give me everything to save you the time clicking all this,
yeah.
Right?
If you go through floors you've already cleared, there's an option to destroy the large malevolence.
So, like, you don't even have to do this floor
yeah,
at all?
Yeah, just basically lets you skip the floor if you've already cleared it. I guess it's an option that's there in case you didn't buy a teleporter.
I mean, do you get to refight the boss?
Yeah.
So that's a very meaningful option if you're farming one of the bosses.
Yeah, since the bosses are refightable here, I'd imagine getting to level 200 with 6x experience this would be a very efficient place to do it.
We should just eat a stick of Barbados butter.
Woo! It's a biggie!
We might remove our ability to use items.
Using the iframes on that to dodge that wall crush attack, which there are a billion different ways to dodge that slow attack. You notice how much Rokuro is helping by not doing anything?
I'll help you!
That was unfortunate. See, now look at this item drawer we have. Yeah, I suggest the item thrower be the character who wasn't doing anything, and it was an improvement to his app general algorithm.
Ready to die? I'm not done with you yet. Here's something for you. Hope you like it. Bounce right. Face your head. No
mercy. Just gets her back in combat. You need to use yours.
Go ahead. Well. Whether I said yes or no, right?
Well, you were about to say go ahead. I heard the G. Don't is an alert.
I think they're dead. Oh. I was not ready for that. I forgot Mystic Arts are terrible. Because they do no hit stun, so you just instantly get hit if you're not ready to be attacked out of them.
Well, you do still have meter, though, in case you need to. Slow is a hilarious status effect in this game, even though it's a god douchebag. That's our lifeblood. What are you doing?
You guys should all bunch up and not hit Eleanor before I can do something good.
Really, Velvet?
They're all at about.
Here it comes! Crimson.
Oh, I started casting, so they instantly decided they cared about me. When I was trying to chase them, they just ran for me. You
yeah.
Saw it, right? Oh, what a surprise, I got slowed as soon as I got hit. If their numbers were reduced by one, I could bring Mogulu back, which would help tremendously.
Let's go, eat it! Let's
go,
eat it!
Salt. You saw how close I was.
Yeah.
Let's go! No escape! No escape! No escape!
Crushing wing!
Let's go!
Hey, they only care about me, so I'm just gonna run in circles around you, okay?
No escape!
You're at the edge of the arena, though.
You know what would have really made me smile? If Rokuro had stolen that.
I was leaving it for you, you're at one.
Rokuro just killed that enemy when I...
Good work, Rokuro.
You you have a lot of meter right now. You could do a lot of stuff.
No escape.
I could not do a lot of stuff.
I'll help you.
Actually. There, now I can do something.
I was really just hoping for a chance. Trying to buy a little time to get Eleanor in a position where I can do this.
Fix yourself, Magla.
There!
Plundering ghost. Plundering ghost grants the amazing ability to fight scorpions.
No escape! No escape!
Lightning, rain down!
Earth and wind call in the spirit! Plundering ghost! Rip them apart! Okay! Plundering ghost! Rip them apart! Okay!
You see how high in the air it went when I uppercutted it?
Tough, I would have liked. We got another main break.
That is. Look at that! Look at that attack power.
Our expedition returned too.
I knew this would be big. What a treasure! Show him how I.
Okay, where are these at?
Are there really only two, or are they
on different levels?
Oh, there's a lot of time. There's probably a lot of them.
I think there's less than there was on some of the other floors. They expect you to be searching for these all over the place. These are built... The time limits are built under the assumption that you didn't use all the,
I don't think we have a chance!
Boons.
Dark and light! I'll help you!
Thanks, game. I appreciated all of that. Thank you, Mogloo. I get to do something.
We did just get the meter from the recipe. There we go. This is what I wanted to do, is to gather up on the ragdoll enemy so that I can just farm the ragdoll enemy for soul while beating the crap out of them.
Elements of creation, I'll help you!
So, I think when I started being able to cast Insubstantiality, it helped us. Would you agree?
I would agree.
It's a really slow spell to cast, but once I start getting it going against enemies weak to void, the effects tend to be hilarious.
It's a really good move. The fact that it's basically two spells in one is the main thing that makes it worth it. And it covers, like...
Its weakness coverage is horrid, though.
Okay, not over here. So these are, looks like they're going to be the only two on this level. What weaknesses does it hit?
Just one. You know, the element Lafayette hits with everything. Lafayette would be a really good character in Zestiria because you would just stack the Void skill on him like 10 times.
Woo! It's a biggie!
Save encounter.
I got two insubstantialities. Oh, that was really a bad time for that. I needed it right.
Sorry,
then.
I didn't. If it makes you feel better, I was doing that to protect you. It backfired. Because I was just trying to get Velvet's Claw out so that you could get back to casting.
Nothing I can do about that.
Timer's running while you're poisoning this, by the way.
It's just stupid. I'm not allowed to do anything. Hey, that was cool when it just ran away from me.
Boy, that was...
You gotta be careful not to die anymore.
We have 9 elixirs and only one boss fight left in the whole game. I'm not really worried about those resources. As worst comes to worst, we just use the elixirs for the boss. Right?
I guess. Why do they make the random encounters that is the part of the game that's not fun so much harder than the bosses? Like, this should be the really easy part of this dungeon, and the bosses should be amped up a lot.
Are we ready for this?
speaking of things that are not fun. Okay. Yeah, all of it. I love getting slowed every time I get hit. It's my favorite part of this enemy. I get nothing. I think I saw it flip me off.
Grape jelly.
That's about to break.
I know. I know what you wanted to do.
Then they give up on that as soon as it would really be to our advantage for them to continue, right? I think I saved you. Where's the timer? Oh, it's just the background.
Oh my goodness. This is
I think they should just use the barrowing attack and then immediately run away as often as possible, don't you?
Yeah.
I mean, if you're throwing a bottle, this is the much more logical choice. You know why I died,
did
right?
Did you throw the bottle? Or did you have Roper throw it?
Because I was holding guard, and I wanted to throw the item and instantly guard. I never want it to work that way, and it works that way in every game, and it's really annoying to me. And now I don't have what I really wanted. Real goal here. It's been my goal for a while. Because she has 5 souls and she can do a lot of damage.
wandering goat! No escape! No escape!
Not good.
Let's go! Eat it! Up! Wide open!
Whirling serpent! Head to the back!
No escape! No escape!
Tougher than you would have liked? You mean completely unenjoyable, Aizen? Because that enemy type just ruins the game. If every enemy were like that, this game would be the worst game in the series.
Yeah. Ugh. Ready for the last boss?
I anticipate this will be really easy. Unlike those scorpions. If they were a giant scorpion, I'd be scared.
The boss is just one of those with a lot of health.
That would be more dangerous than what I anticipated.